Tyson Fury was a cheat. My next question is,
I didn't say that, man. I didn't say that. Don't get me in the middle of that.
No, I ain't gonna do that to you. I know you said you won't discredit a man's win, but we know where your heart is at. So who's the best young prospect you think right now? That Jerron in 3-4 years will be the man.
Jerron Ennis. They call him Boots. He's from, I'm not saying this just because he's from Philadelphia, but that kid got a special talent.
Who? Who'd you say?
Jerron Ennis.
Boots Ennis. Boots Ennis.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, Boots been talking big shit on a couple of days ago.
Hey, man. He's talking to EJ
and Bud.
Now, let me tell you something, man. They better be careful with that kid. I'm telling you. I seen him in the gym up and close and personal. And that kid is nasty, bro. That kid got, I'm not saying he's as good as these people because you got to see him in the top level and you got to see him crack. But he remind me of like a mix of, do you guys remember Mark Too Sharp Johnson? He's the fight out.
Yeah, he goes all the fights now. Yeah.
He's like an inventor now. He like invents stuff. He does patents and everything, believe it or not, Fred. I seen him at a convention in Vegas. He reminds me of a mix of Mark Too Sharp Johnson and Roy Jones, man. Boots Ennis is a talented kid. He's a little bit bigger and longer than Spence and Crawford. He's a lot younger. And that matters, man. You guys may not understand this, but there's a difference between the faculties of a 23-year-old kid and a dude that's 30 and 32. They done took a lot less punishment. You know what I mean? Just the sparring, just going through camps and things like that. I'm telling you, those guys got to be super careful of that kid, man. He's serious. I've seen him in the gym up and close and personal. He sparred my guy several times. That kid can really, really fight. And enjoys boxing. He stays in the gym. You know, he's not going to get no title shot until he becomes a mandatory. Somebody like to talk to him. Ain't nobody giving him no title shot.
I was thinking him versus Sean Porter or something like that. You know what I mean? Because Sean Porter needs to get back on the – I don't think Terrence Crawford's going to fight him.
You talking about innocent Sean Porter?
Yeah, innocent Sean Porter.
You know what? The thing is, though, Fred, is that Ennis is not with PBC.
Oh, he's not?
And with just from everything I know about boxing, this don't have nothing to do with
Showtime. Mm-hmm.
You don't give a kid like if PBC, I doubt if they give a kid like that a chance with one of these standout fighters if he's not with the company. You know what I mean? That's just everything that I know about boxing, you know. Whoever he's with, they're going to have to create some opponents or they're going to have to get somebody some options on the kid because he's that good. Nobody's just going to just fight him and just let him just – I'm not saying that Sean can't beat him. Sean's a dog, but I'm just saying that, like, Sean's at a place right now where he probably wouldn't want to be dealing with no young kid like that to let him make his name. You know what I mean? He can – there's other guys over in the PBC that he can fight. I'm telling you, that kid's a problem, man.
Yeah, the reason why I was saying that was because he already fought the guys already. You know what I mean? He already fought Keith Thurman, and maybe he needs that to bounce back and get like some oomph behind his name. Because
thing about Sean is that he hasn't lost convincingly. Like,
you sure.
know, like all of his fights are competitive.
Round at the max, right?
So he can kind of, he can get a fight, maybe a rematch with Danny Garcia, rematch with Keith Thurman, maybe Manny Pacquiao. He hasn't fought him yet. You know, who knows? I mean, I don't want to play matchmaker for nobody else, but I think there's fights out there for Sean. You know, he's got to figure it out. But I don't know if anybody wants to mess with that kid, man. I'm telling you. I just – he's about 5'11". His arms hang down to his knees.
His arms alone.
He switched southpaw to orthodox. He could punch. He could fight all night. He constantly jabbing. He got these real cat-like reflexes. Young and youthful, you know, Fred, it's like going playing the dude. You come back to your old high school kid, like 17, 18, want to play you one-on-one, man. Sometimes you don't feel like dealing with that crap, man.
Facts.
You know, it's like they, I don't know if they feel like dealing with him, man. You know, Julian got to be in the mood to spar that kid. he can't just be moping around the gym. Like, we got to be in shape to box him, bro. Facts. He ain't nothing to play with. I'm telling you, that kid is serious, man. And I'm not saying you can beat everybody in the welterweight division because you got to go through the progressions and I got to see you get hit by one of those guys. But I would not bet money against him versus anybody in the division. And I'm serious when I say that. I don't care about whatever anybody got to say about experience. Experience sometimes is overrated in the aspect of certain level of fighters get more opportunities than other fighters because they're more vulnerable. So sometimes guys be like, man, I didn't fought everybody. I'm like, yeah, because the matchmakers and the managers know that you're not going to beat everybody. So that's why you keep getting all these opportunities. But a kid like Ennis, he may not have the experience because people not going to fight him. You know what I mean? A prospect going to need a lot of money to